How's it growing, gardeners? It's Saturday, January 9th, and I'll tell you, this is my fourth winter here on the southeastern coast of North Carolina, and while we're liable to get cold shots from time to time and it periodically gets pretty cold at night, this winter has been by far the most consistently cold winter since I've been here. I'd say 2 out of every 3 days must have been 5 to 10 degrees below average as a high ever since Thanksgiving. And as a result, for the first year ever, I've had to take my fig trees, which I normally keep in the center of my property, I've had to move them all up against the house because it's just been so cold. And we're supposed to drop to about 29 degrees Fahrenheit again tonight. So I have most of my fig trees clustered up against the house here for added warmth. And then the ones that are too large to fit, I also have them clustered over here by the house as well to try to keep things as warm as possible. And these trees are taking up quite a lot of room. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to go through my fig trees and I am working on my cull list for the fig trees that I'm going to get rid of this winter because they're just not working out for me in my area. So what I want to do is I'm going to move them out into the open and I'm going to go through with you tree by tree as to which ones are not working out for me, why I am culling them, and why I don't recommend them in humid, rainy summer climates such as mine. If you've been following my channel for a while, you know that I have about 45 different varieties of figs and about 50 trees overall. And for the record, I don't have 45 to 50 trees because I want 45 to 50 fig trees. It's because I'm trialing all of these varieties to find out which ones work in my climate. For those of you that are unaware, figs come from Mediterranean climates. And in Mediterranean climates, they are virtually rainless during the summer. From about June 1st to the end of September, in most Mediterranean climates, they barely get a drop of rain. So figs have evolved to ripen in nearly completely dry, rainless conditions. As such, when rain hits the flesh of the figs, or you overwater your fig trees, the figs have a tendency to swell and burst, and then sour flies get into them and they rot the fruit and they become breeding grounds for larvae and other kinds of flying annoying pests. Now, I live on the southeastern coast of North Carolina and we basically have an inverse Mediterranean climate. Our wettest period of the year is from June 1st to the end of September, where we average anywhere from about 5 to 6 inches of rain every single month, and we get deluge thunderstorms. So because I have such a miserable climate for growing figs, most fig varieties are going to fail in my climate. So I'm searching for the ones that have the best resistance to extreme humidity and deluge rainfall. And those are the ones that I intend to plant in ground. And that is what I've done to date. So my goal has always been to get rid of the majority of figs that I acquire and only plant the superstars in ground that tolerate wet weather and humidity. So in front of me are 6 different fig varieties that I intend to get rid of because they are just not working out for me in my climate. So now I'm going to go through one by one each of these fig varieties, tell you why they're not working out for me in my wet, humid summers and why. The fig tree right in front of me is a common fig called Laterola Italian Honey. And I acquired this fig back in either 2017 or 2018. And last year in 2019, we had a top 10 driest year on record. And this fig right in front of me was awesome during that uncharacteristically hot, dry summer. I got great quality figs off of this tree because it was so dry. Now this year we've had a more characteristic wet, rainy summer. It's actually been an overabundance of rain. I've recorded almost 90 inches of rainfall throughout 2020, so it was really a nasty wet year. And this fig was absolutely miserable in the rain. While it was great in the dry, I lost every single fig off of this tree this past summer. This fig has a very large open eye on the bottom. And because it was so humid, I was having a problem with SWD, which is the spotted winged Drosophila fruit fly. They would crawl up into the open eye and they would lay their larvae and they would sour the figs. So I was having issues with either these figs all exploding on me due to the rainfall or bugs getting into them. And every single fig soured. I didn't get to eat one single fig off of this tree. And that's a shame because it was loaded for bear with figs. It was the first fig that tried ripening for me in the summer. And all of the figs were large at 50 to 60 grams or more. So if you live in a Mediterranean climate or in a climate with drier summers, this is really a fantastic honey fig if you're into green honey figs with light yellow interiors. I would recommend it. But for the humid coast that gets lots of thunderstorms like me down in the southeast, I cannot recommend this fig because what's the point of growing a fig where if you have a typical summer with lots of rain, you're going to lose every single one and just create a breeding ground for pests. So that's why I'm getting rid of Laterola Italian honey. I just don't want to mess around with it anymore. It's just not for me. The fig tree in front of me is from the Spanish island of Mallorca. It's called Col de Dam de Ciutat. It is one of the Col de Dam figs. There are many different Col de Dams, and all of them are outstanding performers in my climate, except for this one. Now, Col de Dam means lady's collar, and they call it that because they have long necks on the fig, kind of like a turtleneck or a collar. This one differs and doesn't seem to fit in with the family. It has a very short neck. And while all of the other Col de Dam figs have deep burgundy red interiors that are typically very thick and delicious and jammy, this one has a lighter, more amber interior, at least in locations that are not caprified by the fig wasp like mine. The problem that this fig tree has is similar to the Laterola Italian honey. It has a big open eye. It does not handle the humidity. It attracts tons of bugs and sour flies. And this tree has a huge tendency to drop all of its figs, probably because it does not like my humid, wet climate. So I just don't think this is a fig that is well adapted to my area. And it's a shame because almost all the other Col de Dams are. Again, if you live in a semi-arid climate or a climate that has a Mediterranean bend to the precipitation patterns, or it just has hot, dry summers, I think this fig has the potential to be really good. It is a nice looking fig. It's very sweet. The problem is it just doesn't ripen for me in my climate. It's a magnet for pests and it swells and bursts. And once again, I was not able to harvest and eat a single fig off of this tree for me last year because it was so wet and humid. So there's no point in growing a fig that I can't eat. So I'm forced to cull this one. Again, if you live in a more western, drier climate, you may have better luck with this, but unfortunately, here in the rainy southeast, it's just not worth it for me. In front of me are two fig trees that I am going to cull. They are both very similar. The one on the left is called Sangue de Drago Rosso, which means red dragon's blood, and the fig tree on the right is called Sangue de Drago Buccia Marrone, which means dragon's blood, brown skin. Both of these varieties I took a risk on. They were unproven varieties from an Italian fig seller named Francesco LaRosso. He lives in Italy, and it was not known if these were common figs. Common figs mean parthenocarpic, which means they will set fruit without pollination from a male capper fig and the fig wasp. Those are the only types of figs that you can grow in North Carolina or outside of California in the United States, because that California is the only place that colonizes the fig wasp, which is required to pollinate figs. I took a gamble on these. I wanted to see if they'd be common. They are not. They will not set figs in my environment. 100% of the figs drop once they hit mid-stage, about 60 days in. So I cannot ripen these two fig trees here. There's no point in growing them because they don't grow outside of the wasp-laden pockets of California. One thing worth noting is they are both incredibly vigorous. So if you live in the Sacramento River Valley or the San Joaquin River Valley in California, and you know that you colonized the wasp nearby, these may be awesome varieties for you to grow because, man, they're just monsters. Or they can make good rootstock if you live in a climate where you're comfortable with grafting your fig trees and the trees don't die down to the roots. Really good rootstock trees, can't grow them in North Carolina, they're getting culled. This smaller fig tree right here is another Francesco LaRosso variety that I rolled the dice on and lost. It appears to be a Smyrna or at least a San Pedro type. It is not a common fig. It will not set fruit without pollination, at least in my climate. I grew it out for 2 summers, and both summers it set a ton of figs and dropped them all, just like the other 2 fig trees that I just went over. This tree does not appear to be nearly as vigorous, so I don't even think it would make good rootstock for grafting. Because of those reasons, it is getting culled from my garden. And this fig tree right in front of me, unfortunately, is my raspberry latte fig tree. This fig tree actually performed fairly well for me its first year in my dry summer back in 2019. But unfortunately, it has a habit of dropping figs. And in my wet summer this past 2020, this fig dropped all of its figs. So I wasn't able to eat a single fig off this tree. This one's a bit of a heartbreaker for me because it performs well in my climate when it does hold its fruits. And it is a possibility that it will hold on to its fruits better as it ages, but I just don't feel like waiting. This is an incredibly vigorous variety. Again, look at this monster. Look at the caliper on this. It's been in this bucket for 2 seasons and has a huge caliper. It shoots out figs in all directions. It's a really great fig tree if you can get it to hold its fruit. But unfortunately, it won't for me, and I just have too many trees as it is, so it just isn't going to make the cut because of that. I'm sorry to say goodbye to Raspberry Latte, but I just don't want to mess with it anymore. And those are all the fig trees that I am going to cull. To be honest, a few more of them almost made the fig culling list. 2 of them that I almost got rid of were Meteorito and Strawberry Teardrop, because they dropped 100% of their figs for me. So they may be a Smyrna variety that require pollination. However, both figs are reportedly so good when they do set, at least in California. I want to give these another try. I'll give them a second season before I get rid of them. 2 other figs that I was thinking about culling were Chicago Hardy and Marseille Black VS. They are both very similar. They're Mount Etna type figs. And so is my Sal Miguel Roxo, aka Azores Dark fig tree. And the Sal Miguel Roxo just kicks the pants off of Chicago Hardy and Marseille Black in terms of fig quality. It's also a Mount Etna type, and it just blows the other two away. But the problem I have is too many of my figs don't ripen early enough, and most of my fig trees are small enough that I still don't have a whole lot of figs. So I'm going to hold on to both Marseille Black and Chicago Hardy for at least another season, because they're both early and I get figs off of them quickly. And I'll take any fig I can get right now because I just love them so much. Once all my trees get more mature and really start cranking out figs, I'll probably cull them. That will require my Sal Miguel Roxo to get a lot larger and more vigorous. I will be planting that one in ground this year. So everyone, those are the fig trees that I'm culling this year and why. I sure hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please hit that like button. And if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please subscribe for future updates and more videos like these. If you're curious about any of the products that I use in my garden, everything I use is linked in my Amazon storefront in the video description. If you use any of our product links, even if you don't buy that product, we get a little commission off of that from Amazon, and it helps me keep making these videos, so I would appreciate it if you could use it. Thank you all again so much for watching, and I hope to see all of you again on the next video. It's such a beautiful day to go out for a walk, Dale. All along the river. What are you looking at? He's hot on the trail or something. And he found it. The secret trash can of goodness.